Realization of spatial data mining. There are lots of microcosmic data existing in the e-government information system coming from different sectors and different periods of time, which mainly includes vector data, raster data, attribute data and a lot of statistical data, etc. It is necessary for the above-mentioned data to be stored in the multi-dimension dataset in accordance with multi-topics to achieve the course of fixed and random dynamic data query processing, comprehensive analysis. Users can access the multi-dimension dataset in the end of client and extract correlative data from the dataset in the background according to different rights, and selected theme demands and finally generate a variety of visual results, such as various statistical graphics, histograms, pie charts, pyramid diagram, etc., and statistical analysis of statements, and so on. Meanwhile, some corresponding multidimensional analysis aiming at disposal results, such as cluster analysis, can also be made. In the next section, the raster data mining will be made as an example to prescribe the whole process. Raster data roots in 1:250,000 data cropped in a certain region of Guizhou province, China. Grid processing is completed by using grids, each grid represents 100 meters x 100 meters, in the region. A pivot can be got in each grid and imported into the relational database to be a record. The picked data includes grid number, terrain slope, terrain aspect, grid coordinates, land use type and land cover type, etc. There are more than 280 records generated in the region. Slope and aspect, which are correlative each other, are parameters commonly used to describe the terrain. Slope reflects the inclination degree of slope and the latter represents the direction which the slope faces. In terms of land use and land cover, the slope and aspect have many uses. For example, the slope exceeding 35 degrees should not be developed in general in the agricultural land development. Slope is the function of points, which is the angle between the normal direction non-vertical directions aiming at a certain point in the surface and can be represented using alpha. In practice, it is no use in computing the slope of each point. Average slope of a basic grid unit is often used to represent corresponding signification. Aspect is the angle between the projection of normal direction and the due direction, that is, the direction of azimuth between the projection vectors. Beta is often to be described to represent the aspect. See Fig.2. Terrain slope and aspect. Elevation representation. Barento, H1, H2, H3, H4 is respectively the elevation of four corner points in the grid, dis the grid length of each side. Similarly, DX, DI represents respectively grid length of horizontal or vertical side, H1, J plus 1, H2, J plus 1, H1, J, H2, G notes respectively the elevation of four corner points in the grid. See Fig.3. The created content of data during the course of being cropped can be described as follows, which takes slope for example. See Fig.4. Slope data in a certain region. In Fig.4, NCALS represents the list of the raster and RAL shows the rows. And X11 corner, Y11 corner represent respectively the coordinates of left underside corner in the whole raster range. Besides, cell size notes the grid size, which can be expressed in the manner of meter. Corresponding values can be got by using procedures to import the above-mentioned data into the relational databases of SQL Server 2000. These values may be arranged in the sequence of known row or list number. For example, corresponding value is i, j plus 1 respectively when id equals 1, 2. Similar conclusions can also be made. The arrangement method of raster data can be described in Table 1 and Figure 5. Arrangement method of raster data. Arrangement method of slope. Each star type model includes a fact table and some corresponding dimension tables. All the fact tables and dimension tables are stored in the SQL Server 2000 database. The key of constructing a star type model is to design right fact table and dimension table as well as establish mutual connections between them. These tables can reflect the complex relationship among different data. Furthermore, too much redundant data can be produced if using one-dimension table to describe due to corresponding complexity of relationship and data in the dimension in practice. Here, the dimension can be divided once again. Some branches will appear from the angle of star, thus, a derived star type model, which is also called snowflake type model, would come into being. The derived star type model established in this section has a specific theme on land use and land cover. Here is an example happened in a certain region of Guizhou province. In the fact table, i.e. combined table, it mainly stores the main code, which is represented with gridded, and the values of slope and aspect in each grid. The latter can be extracted automatically from DIM by making use of relevant designing program. Designed fact table can be described as follows in Figure 6. Designed fact table. Dimensional tables mainly include three tables, Therento, dimensional table of grid can store each grid's main code used to link fact table, row number, list number, coordinates and the codes of land use and land cover. The dimensional table of land cover can store corresponding attributed value, such as land cover denomination, region name. The dimensional of land utilization, similar to land cover table, stores the attributed value corresponding with grid table, such as land utilization denomination, region name, etc. Dimensional tables of land cover, land utilization, grid can be described respectively as follows in Fig.7, Fig.8 and Fig.9. Dimension of land cover. Dimension of land utilization. Compared with traditional approach, the main difference of constructing multi-dimensions data set based on raster data in this section is the dissimilarity of forming star type model. Necessary data grouping processing can be adopted in order to improve the system function because the raster data amount is quite larger. In this section, all the raster data can be divided into more than 700 groups. Data of each group may arrange in the sequence of keyword. Dimension of grid. New multi-dimensions data set can be constructed after adopting snowflake type framework. As shown in Figure 10, dimensions of land cover on land utilization act as the branches of dimension of grid. Multi-dimension data set. Process of data mining based on raster, similar to the one of data mining based on vector, has also included model creation, example dimension choice and forecasting the entities and data to be trained as well as the model processing, and so on. At present, there are many spatial data mining algorithms, such as statistical analysis, neural networks, clustering, decision trees, genetic algorithm, classification, etc. In this section, clustering algorithm is mainly used to deal with the raster data stored in e-government information system. In the processing course of clustering algorithm, diverse data can be divided into different categories in order to make the difference between categories as big as possible and inner differences in the category as small as possible. Clustering algorithm, which is also called aggregation algorithm, is an indirect data mining algorithm and does not use independent variables to get designated output. Different from classification model, clustering algorithm does not know beforehand that there are several categories to be divided and what these categories are. And it does not know how to define these categories according to some data items. Although it cannot predict unknown data value, while classification algorithm can, it provides a way to find similar records. These records can be considered the components of given clusters according to self-determined algorithm itself. The following section has described the course of data mining by using constructing clustering. In this section, data mining is made based on the algorithm of M. The algorithm is one of spatial clustering algorithms, which adopts the probability method of distribute each data to the determined classification instead of calculating directly the distance. Set up a closed curve in each dimension as the clustering criteria, and calculate the mean and standard variance. If the point falls within the closed curve, then they have a certain probability of belonging to the given classification. Since the different curve of corresponding classification is not only, so the data point may also fall in multiple classification curves and is given a different probability. During the course of implementation, the initial classification model is repeatedly made to finish the step of optimization by the algorithm to fit the data, and determine the probability of data point existing in a classification. When the probability model fits the data, the algorithm terminates the process. The function to determine the suitability is the logarithmic likelihood data fitting the model. In this process, if an empty classification is generated or the membership of one or more categories is less than a given threshold, new data point will be received in the classification with low fill rate, and the algorithm will rerun. As the results of the M cluster analysis algorithm is probabilistic, which means that each data point belongs to all categories, and calculates a probability for each combination of data point and the classification, but the data point is allocated to the classification of each with a different probability.